Anything new to add to your introduction today? Last time you had given a very good introduction, you remember?
Yes.
Still it is in the memory of all your interview. Something more to add?
Nothing.
If you are comfortable, take out the mask.
Yes.
Okay, good for you. Okay, anything more to add to the introduction?
No, sir. Hmm?
Anything more to speak?
Sir, about
Jagatsinghpur?
On Jagatsinghpur.
Jagatsinghpur. Sir, about current affairs?
Anything that you'd like to. We are giving it a very open base.
Yes, sir.
You can write anything that you. On Jagatsinghpur.
Sir, recently a rural economic corridor is proposed to be built in Jagatsinghpur. And recently it is announced by the collector of Jagatsinghpur.
What is this rural economic?
Sir, the rural economic corridor, it will help the local people of that area and also the farmers and the people of that area to sell their produce from their farms to the markets. It directly connected road, and it will also help the people to go to the hospitals also. It was a very backward area and recently it is announced. So.
So can you tell something about our 5T system in the government?
Yes, sir. Sir, the 5T initiative is started by our Chief Minister Navin Patnaikji, and it stands for transparency, technology and teamwork in a time-bound manner, and that will lead to transformation of the whole system of the government administrative system, and it helps in eradicating corruption also, and it will just modernize our system of working of administration.
MoSarkar, can you speak something about what is MoSarkar? Again, sir.
Sir, MoSarkar माने गोटे प्लाटफर्म अच्छे जो थे कि जो मैंने आसुचान गवर्नमेंट ऑफिसर्स को जमी हॉस्पिटल हो जाओ से मानक दे विल गेट सर्विस विथ डिग्निटी इट इज अ प्लाटफर्म फॉर फीडबैक Sir, Sharia law is a very backward kind of law, I would say. Like in today's world, we have modern ideas like democracy, liberty, equality, fraternity, and Sharia law it is very backward in the sense of we have to stick with restrictions like in food habits. Dress code and all these things.
What do you would like to know about this? What are the provisions of the Sharia law?
Sir, I don't know in details, but I know that.
Whatever you know, you can share with us.
Sir, Sharia law means I will tell about women. They can't go alone outside. They need to have a male companion with them, and women can't have education. Also, so what and
they will not pursue his business.
No, sir. If they allow, then women can then only pursue education. It's not. There is no freedom in it. I'd say. Then restrictions on everything, going outside and pursuing their career, and there is no liberty at all. I'd say. Now, ठीक
है तो और दरकार बने.
Clarity.
Clarity. what is this area law. So you need to have little. See, Amara Vartan, what are the important features of this national education policy that has come recently?
Yes, sir.
And any specific features?
Sir, we have that 10 plus 2 and plus 3 system, and it has modernized it now. We will now get 5 plus 3 plus 3 plus 4. This type of pattern we will get now. And it is morely focused on social and emotional intelligence of the persons. Like it has multiple exit and entry system also.
What is this multiple exit and entry?
Yes, sir. Sir, suppose we are doing a BSc degree, or we have 3 years in total, then it is not compulsory that we have to do the 3 years and then we can only exit the college. We can exit it in first year also, second year also, and third year also. And for each year, they will provide some different certificates, like diploma certificate and degree certificate, like this.
Okay,
ma'am. Yes, sir, with the connecting question of national education policy, is there any emphasis on the vocational education?
Yes, ma'am. There is a very broad focus on this vocational education. It will the vocational education, it will reduce the problem of unemployment to the rural and the urban youth also. And yeah, it will also provide skills to the youth of the country and the region also.
Okay, Sainaj, do you know there is a for skill development of the youth, youngest youth, there is a department in the government of Odisha, can you name it?
I'm sorry, I'm not aware of it.
Okay, Skill Development and Technical Education Department, Skill Government of Odisha. Skill Development and Technical Education Department in Government of Odisha.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Sairaj, please tell something about the special advantages that has been given by our government to the minorities.
Yes, ma'am. There are certain schemes which are given to the minority community, like Roshni scheme and...
What is the objective of that Roshni scheme?
Ma'am, it is basically giving skills to the minority community. And another scheme is there, which is called Ustad scheme. It will empower the artisans of minority community, and it will enrich their skills, like artifacts. They are making artifacts. It will, the government will give them skills, and then it will go to the market for the sell. And
okay, Sainaj, could you call some of the major contribution of Maulana Abul Kalam Azad?
Yes, ma'am. Maulana Abul Kalam Azad, he was the first education minister of our country, Free India, and after his name there is a scholarship also which are given to minorities, Maulana Abul Kalam Azad scholarship scheme. And he took part in non-cooperation movement, then civil disobedience movement also, and he was a very prominent person in Indian independence struggle also. And he started also.
Okay, Sainaj, yes. Could you tell also one minority community of Odisha who has a prominent role, who played a prominent role in our freedom fighting struggle?
Sorry, ma'am, I'm not aware of it.
Could you also tell something about the Khan Abdul Ghaffar Khan?
Yes, ma'am. Ma'am, he is called Frontier Gandhi. And Sarinde Gandhi.
Why?
Because his ideal was Mahatma Gandhi ji. And in Afghanistan, in northwest frontier province area, he took the civil disobedience movement at a very high level there. And he also idealized Mahatma Gandhi a lot, and he took the elements like truth, non-violence, and non-cooperation of this ideas of Gandhiji. So he is called Frontier Gandhi, and he also took part in a especially he was concerned with the civil disobedience movement of 1930s round.
In this Gurkha system, do you find any scientific reason covering the entire body, the scientific benefits of this Gurkha system?
Yes, ma'am. Ma'am, during this pandemic times, we are told that just don't go outside or don't expose your body so that the germs could contract you. So I think the scientific in wearing burqa is that if you wear burqa, our body will not expose to those germs and viruses. So in that terms, it is good. And but overall, I would say if any woman she wants to wear it, then it's okay. In if any woman she doesn't want to wear it, there should not be any compulsion on her to make her wear that burqa.
Okay, any scientific reason of only black color?
Well, most of the women they wear black. There are other colors too, like light blue and white also they wear.
Okay, Sainas, please tell something about the three-tier system of our government.
Yes, ma'am. Ma'am, in Panchayati Raj?
Yes, ma'am.
In Panchayati Raj, we have Gram Panchayat, then Panchayat Samiti and Zilla Parishad at the district level.
Could you tell also something about the role of the Election Commission of India?
Ma'am, Election Commission of India is a constitutional body which ensures free and fair election to the state legislature and the Parliament of India, and it also make awareness about the election procedures, and it also make arrangements before the election time, like conducts the model code of conduct and all that. It allows symbol to the parties and make recognition to the national parties and the state regional parties also.
Okay, Sainas, my last question to you. Yes, what is your response to the ban of the triple talaq by Supreme Court of India?
Yes, ma'am. Ma'am, it's a good move by Supreme Court of India. By banning the triple talaq, it gives women a good, it leads to women empowerment, I would say. Like in this 21st century, we can't say three times talaq, and you will just dump woman. You can't say like this. There should be some proper legislative framework to conduct the, if you want divorce, just go to the court and follow a proper framework and system, so that just give the woman the alimony if she wants that, and
okay, sir. Sahil.
Yes, sir.
We have sociology.
Yes.
So what is polygyny?
Polygamy. Yes, sir.
Polygyny.
Polygyny, sir. It is also called polygamy. Polygyny
is called polygamy. Only.
A man can marry more than one woman, different women.
Polyandry.
So in polyandry, a woman can marry more than one man.
Is there any example of polyandry in Odisha?
Sir, polyandry in Odisha.
Polygamy?
Polygamy. Sir, I don't know, sir.
Polygamy is not prevalent in Odisha?
Sir, I don't think so.
You say polygamy means one man marries several women.
Women, yes, sir.
Is it not available?
Sir, in Odisha.
In which community it is available?
Sir, basically it is prevalent in minorities community. Yes, sir.
Muslim.
Yes, sir.
But is sororate polygamy. Sororate polygamy.
Sorry, sir, I'm not aware of this. Sorry.
Sororate polygamy means.
Yes.
Polygamy means a man marries several.
There is different women. Yes, sir.
In sororate polygamy, man marries to the sisters.
Sisters.
ताकि बाहला ता साड़ी की बाहर कराव जिति भोनी थी सो सरोरे ओके सरोरे पुलिगा ओके
यस सर
यू हैव आल्सो हिस्ट्री
यस सर
द ईयर 1990
यस सर
द ईयर
1990
इन मॉडर्न इंडियन हिस्ट्री व्हाई सो इंपॉर्टेंट
सर 1919 और 1990
1919
Yes, sir. Sir, in 1919, Rowlatt Act has come into place. Rowlatt Act, by which the seditious, according to the Britishers, the seditious acts they are dealt with charges without any trial. They will just put the people in the jail without any trial procedure, and after that. There is on Baisakhi day there was a conglomeration of people, women, children at the Jallianwala Bagh park, and they are peacefully protesting that Rowlatt Act, and suddenly the General Dyer come and just shoot at the crowd, and many women, children, they also died in that thing. And in 1919 also, Montague-Kempsford reforms have passed 1919 also.
And 1919, that means you say it is Jallianwala Bagh?
Yes, sir.
Rowlatt Act?
Yes, sir.
Then?
Yes, sir, Montague-Kempsford reforms.
Oh.
Yes, sir.
Is there any other event attached to this year?
1919. Sorry, sir, I'm not able to recall all.
Any world event attached to this year?
Sir, yes, the World War One has just ended in 1919. Yes.
Then, what is history and what is prehistory? What is the basic difference between?
Yes, sir. Sir, in history, we have evidences, like we have inscriptions and archaeological evidence, like inscriptions, coin, monuments, and in literary evidence also. But in prehistory, the Stone Age was going on in prehistory, and we don't have any written evidence of that time, like literary evidence we don't have of prehistory.
When you said the history, you said prehistory. What is protohistory?
So protohistory is that period in which we have the literary evidences, written evidences.
Do you have any idea about civilization?
Civilization.
Indus Valley civilization.
Yes, sir.
You have idea?
Yes, sir.
Can you cite some examples, place in India?
Yes, sir. Sir, recently the Rakhigarhi, it has emerged as one of the largest. It is the largest Harappan site till date, and it is located in Haryana. And some others are Lothal and Rakhigarhi. Then Banwali also. These are some places of Indus Valley civilization in India.
Kalibangan?
Kalibangan is also there, yes sir. Kalibangan.
Okay. See, you are very good.
Thanks.
Your approach is also very good. Your way of thinking also is very good.
Yes, sir.
And you correctly tell the answers. But in some there is little confusion.
Yes, sir.
Ingredient.
Yes, sir.
History, prehistory, protohistory. It's a very fundamental question because you have history optional.
Yes, sir.
And nicely we have summarized 1919 event.
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, Sainaj, why did you fail to come to this board for the second time?
No, ma'am, I have
what thinking what you decided to come for the second time?
Yes, ma'am, I just come to seeing you intellectual people and interacting with you, and yesterday when I came last time, you just gave me some positive vibe also. That gave me confidence, and so I decided to come once again in
okay.
this world.
When did your date of interview?
Ma'am, 29.
Okay.
So I decided to just end.
What is your hobby?
Sir, it's dancing and playing badminton.
What do you dance?
Yes, sir. I just like to dance. I have participated in many school functions and college fairs also.
Okay, you are a very prospective candidate, and you have also knowledge and intelligence in various laws relating to the minorities as well as the Indian constitution also. And you have also idea of your district, but as I told that, we have some more information about the laws, your
Sharia laws and pre-history, photo-history.
Yes. And your communication skill is very fine, and convincing skill is also very fine.
Yes.
And we are hopeful that you will definitely find a name on the final notification list.
Thank
of
you.
The OCS.
Thank
yeah.
you.
Okay, I think
okay.
I think you must have got the right feedback.
Yes, sir.
And
in the dancing, what you should be very clear about what dance? Do you dance with that Odissi dance?
No, sir, not classical, but like semi-classical and modern dance. We dance in school. Dalkhai Sambalpuri
yes.
dance,
yes,
we
yes.
have done that in school time, and in college also we have done Garba, Ghuma and all this.
In our leisure time we do like this,
yes,
a lot
sir.
Of
first Garba Koilo, Kojagara Seta.
Sir, Gujarat.
How do you
call
it?
Ghumar also,
Rajasthan. Yes, Rajasthan.
Kojagara Seta. से पचारूँच बोर्ड रे मैंने दे आर ट्राइंग टू एक्सपोज योर सेल्फ योर इंटेलेक्चुअलिटी योर नॉलेज से कहूँ से पचारूँ डांस क्लासिकल की कौन ओडिसी की कौन ओडिसी जी तुम्हें कह हाँ तेने ओडिसी विषय पचारे कौन लय कौन ताल कौन भाव कौन बुझेगा तुम्हें जी संबलपुरी कथा कह पुणी थे तुमको संबलपुरी डांस पचारे तुम जहाँ कह डांस कर सेटा को क्लियर हो कोटा कहिब हम ताई विषय रे किसी किसी आइडिया न हो सो दैट जदी से माने क्रॉस क्वेश्चन पर करन के कोन कोई ओके
थैंक यू सर द फेस साइन
ऑल द बेस्ट